All right, I'm having an awesome day today. I did have to have a little relief fantasizing today, but I managed to control myself, so it was all right. But I indulged in some fantasizing. But I kept myself in check, though. And I did not release my seed. I went to one of those cam girl sites, and used my intentions, and I just found just the right girl, and we both knew that we were communicating with each other. I overdid a little bit, but you know, I went too long. You know, I really just needed to just have a nice, good feeling. So I've been doing a lot of work this week, and I did one of the final pieces of the puzzle for my ATM card for the trust account that I'm going to manifest. And one of the bankers emailed me, so now I'm on email communication with the banker. So that's cool. My next goal is to actually get into email communication with the criminal investigation department. I found that's the way I like to do business, is email, now that all my major affidavits are already in the public record and sent to the corporations. So that's the wave, communication wave of the future is email. After that, the communication wave is going to be video, and then live video. They already have it already set up. We can go live on video and on YouTube, go in each other's rooms and talk to each other there. So, but until I'm able to get my ATM card, and or at first have my be able to write my trust checks and have those honored, then I can get some up-to-date computer equipment, then I can go room to room. So, but the main thing about masturbation, you know, I'm one of those guys that can talk about anything, but the main thing about masturbation is I've been experimenting with masturbation now for the past 5 years, and I'm in one of those modes right now where I found it's best to keep my seed in. So now I'm experimenting with just having erections and you know, a little bit of fondling, and you know, just to reach the orgasmic release, but you know, no semen coming out. Now, a lot of guys do this by what they call squeezing the PC muscle, but I've tried that, and I've had some success at it. I got halfway there, but then my conscience got to me, and I quit masturbating. But we don't have to tense up our PC muscle. We can just be nice and relaxed, and we can get to the point of an orgasm where the genital does contract, pulsates, but no fluid comes out, and that's just something that I've discovered actually on a real girl. I discovered it for the first time. That was back in early 2000s. And I said, wow, this is kind of cool. You just go all night like this. Just go nice and slow. It's just slow, slow, slow. And then you when you're about to come, you just realize you are, and you stop any motion, and you can just you finally get used to it. Oh, it's just a pulsation. The muscles squeeze and everything. And you get that feeling of ejaculation, nothing comes out. It's not as good feeling, you know, because a full ejaculation, you know, you put a lot of emphasis into it and a lot of emotions and noise and moaning and stuff like that, and that all adds to the release. But so anyway, that's what I did a little bit here today. But that wasn't why the day turned out good. The day has been turning out good because last night I found a Eckhart Tolle video, and the link's in one of my other videos. So I made a copy of it and played it over and over again. And I was able to... I just realized I was all way in my brain right then. Okay, so for the first 6 minutes of this video, I was totally in my mind. I was locked out. I forgot about my space. Okay. Now I'm here. I'm finding my balance. But that Eckhart Tolle video helped me find my balance, add to my balance, because I played it over and over and over again, and I brought up a text and I started typing notes. I had like 50 sentences worth of notes. But even before that, there was this YouTuber called Story Waters, and he totally took me to the next level of overcoming, of letting go of resistance. And he helped me so much that I went and I watched a Miley Cyrus video called Wrecking Ball. And I've watched it before. But all of a sudden, it was just like me and the universe were having a direct conversation through her eyes in the video. And I started feeling the teary feeling, you know, releasing thorns and stuff like that. And then I went to one of her, on the side of the videos, one of her younger videos where she has her hair, beautiful hair and all that. And I think I've seen the video before, but I never really paid attention to her beauty and to the her facial structure. How hair makes a big difference in bringing out the beauty of facial structure. You know, long hair. And I was just like, and it just hit me. I was like so struck by her beauty. And that I just totally, the tears just started coming down. Whew. And I went through a period of like, damn, is Miley Cyrus and me supposed to hook up? But then I overcame that and was like, no, this is just the universe. This is the female side of the universe communicating with me. That led to another video by a couple other popular young women that sing. And the same thing happened again, man. And then for the third one, it happened again. Then it started to finally subside, and I realized, whoa, it's not the women. There's not a connection with the women here. It's the female side of the universe that's showing me that sensitive, letting go of resistance side. And something was planted in me. And like I said, then I saw that Eckhart Tolle video last night. And it just added to my strength. And not to mention the fact that I've been, ever since I went on the internet here, because I've been a year without internet, ever since I went on the internet, you know, all of a sudden I just got a refresher course on all the Abraham videos, the Law of Attraction, you know, the stuff that I've been learning. And because I went out in the backyard and I, like a yogi, and I discovered all kinds of stuff by myself, just me and nature and some cannabis. And so when I got to get back on the internet again, everything just started building again quickly. And I realized, wow, look how I've grown. And look how I'm able to find that balance with my third eye and how I'm able to see exactly what's going on with something that makes sense to me, and how to find that balance between the outer eyes and the outer ears, keeping my attention on the outside world. Even though I'm in the house, this is all manufactured goods, and I learn how to listen to Mother Nature and how she speaks to me through the signs, and how to expect stuff, Mother Nature to speak to me, the universe to speak to me, moment by moment, every moment, just to be in the moment of now. And it's easy for me because I don't have to work a job. I'm not distracted by anything. And it's been like that way now totally since I quit trading Forex market about 2 or 3 years ago. Just totally been released to just do my own thing. No job, no nothing. I'd sold stuff on Craigslist just to pay the bills so I could have internet and food and stuff like that. But then I decided to quit doing that and just go moneyless. Go full bore and see if my lean would stand on its own. And it did. I've gone through so much fear and overcome so much fear. And now I'm going to the next and final level. And that's getting the Department of Justice and the World Court involved in my situation with CID. This is like the final pinnacle for me. I am going to manifest that ATM card, and I'm going to be able to show you all how to do it once this is all done. And quickly, the United States is going to, people from the information that I'm going to get, I'm going to be able to show so many people how to do this and how to stand. And the United States is going to spread like fire, and it's going to spread throughout the whole earth, and we're just going to, everything's going to start to move in a quantum leap now. There ain't going to be no more war. Even if the Trinity Broadcasting Network, you know, that I've come back to like again, even if their prophets on there say there's going to be war because of their interpretation of the Bible, there ain't going to be no more war. It's going to come to an end here soon. Terrorism and all that's going to be wrapped up real quick here. And we're going to go into the rehab mode for all pirates and terrorists. The only war that's going to be is called the pen and paper war. That's what the Book of Revelations is talking about. And that has to do with the animal brain and the upper brain. That war between the brain, between our thinking. It's that war of finally being able to come into the moment. But you have to have that claim lean, because that makes the whole bit of difference. Because we live in a system called Prison Planet, which the universe calls phase two of our evolution. Because we used to be in the kill or kill be world of the jungle. So the universe put us all into prison to rehabilitate us, to teach us, put us under rules, to teach us how to be peaceful. So that now, with the third phase that we're transiting into, is the mind shift. And we'll be able to put our claim liens in. And that's the only way you can sign yourself out of the legal system, is to use the paperwork, pen and paper. It's lawful paperwork, but it does fall under the understanding of the legal paperwork system, because that's the only thing that the administrators in the legal system and the lawful system have agreed to, that's understandable to both sides. So you had to put that claim lien in. And then you can do whatever, experiment with it any way you want. And I went through my own experimenting with it. And I wanted to do that first before I even attempted to pay for anything. I had to see it that claim lien stand on its own. And I had the desire to go through every step of the way. And I took it slow, 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 every step of the way. Everything that came at me, I took it real slow. And I was rewarded because of that. I've been given a phenomenal amount of knowledge, wisdom, and understanding on how this earth works because of my willingness to take things so, so slow. So, yeah, like I said, you know, I'm learning that being in the present moment is the most healthiest thing to be in, and it does help us to slow down. And, but like I said, you know, I've been without internet for so long. Once I got back another taste of the internet, I just had to ejaculate all my energy out. And it's starting to come to a close. I can feel it, but I still get kind of hyped up when I watch Benny Hinn videos and stuff like that. And that's all good energy because I'm learning how to be focused and balanced with my third eye, watching my thoughts go by at the same time in synchronicity with everything that's going on around me, and expecting the universe to show me, reveal to me my desires coming, manifesting. And signs, step by step, everything I see on the internet, my cats will walk in the room, synchronized with my thoughts. And, you know, it's all coming together. And it's increasing and it's growing. And it's pretty cool. Even right now, I'm still going a little bit too fast because I can feel my root chakra is starting to burn. Because I'm talking too fast. I actually need to slow down more. But I'll get there. Yeah. I just wanted to say that man, it's been a good day today. Real good day. And I foresee all other days just growing and increasing. Reason being is because I don't have to work. I can put 100% of my energy and focus on being balanced all day. And I catch myself. Sometimes I'll go like 15 seconds on, 15 seconds off. Like when I started this video, I went 6 minutes. That's because I started talking about masturbation. I was a little bit uncomfortable with it. And but at heart, I'm fully comfortable. I have no qualms speaking anything. I can talk to any subject. So can my mother. That's the relationship me and my mother have. There are no secrets between her and I. That's why we are the royal family. That's why I'm the prince. She's the queen. My dad's the king. Now, my dad, he's not open to speaking. Everything with him is secret. And there's a reason behind that. And I'm not going to say right now. But for those of you who have ears to hear, you could probably figure out what it might be. But it's no secret. All of our names are in the public record. Everyone can go check out the public record, see what our names are. Everyone in this area where we live, you know, it's no secret who we are and what we've went through. Yeah. That's why the universe is gonna totally honor my family. And yes, we are the real royal family. We've been underground, undercover. And all the royal families that are out in the public right now over in England are just there to protect us because we had to go undercover. So, and they all know it. So, and there's no hostility between us and them. They all understand. Obama knows, Eric Holder knows, and the new Secretary of Defense, Ash Carter, they all know. Everybody at the highest levels all know who we are. And it's going to be all known to all the public throughout the whole world who we are. So, yeah. So like I said, I don't have to work a job. I don't have to do nothing. I don't do nothing for nobody except for share knowledge on the internet. I don't collect no money from nobody. I totally live money free. I've been doing it for the past, I think, 2 years now. Absolutely no money. I go to the food bank. I go to Catholic Community Services to get wood to burn. Toothpaste to brush my teeth, soap. I use the shower facilities out in town. And St. Vincent de Paul in the other city, they have what's called a service station where all the homeless go. You get free laundry there. And not to mention, the lien that I put in caused the local Four Square Church over here to provide free laundry for me and the rest of the community. So, yes, and all the administrators around here know who I am and all my paperwork, and I got the highest respect from everybody. And neighbors, the whole nine yards. So, but there's a lot of people, a lot of the citizens who don't know my status, though, as far as being the royal family. Just the neighbors around who I announced on my radio station out in the backyard. So, but I am totally protected at the highest level, all the way to the CIA, to the FBI, to the international military. Because I am the key player for the whole earth to get this information to everybody, because I'm the one who knows how to explain it to people thoroughly in a peaceful way so that people don't riot. Train myself to do this, so. So yeah, like I said, I don't work a job, so I can put 100% focus on healing myself, and that's what's going to heal the rest of the world. I'm not trying to fix anybody else. I'm just trying to fix myself. So, as above, so below. As I go, so the people go. As America goes, so the rest of the world goes. As Earth goes, so the rest of the planets go. As the rest of the planets go, so the rest of the universe goes, so on and so forth. That's the law of correspondence, described through the phrase of as above, so below. I just wanted to make a video on that and put that on the public record and for anybody who wants to view the public record. All right, talk to you later.